Dr. Jeremy Weisz here. I'm founder of InspiredInsider.com, where I talk with inspirational entrepreneurs and leaders like founders of P90 X, Baby Einstein, Atari, how they overcome big challenges in life and business. Today, we have SteveSipress, who's a successful entrepreneur and top direct response marketer who's built nearly a dozen successful companies, including simulated sports services, winner circle promotions, and many more. But he prefers to the vicarious thrill by coaching many businesses himself. Some people referred to him as the king of small business makeovers. He will share his big lessons learned and the wow strategy, which helps businesses increase sales and marketing. Steve, thanks for joining me.
Pleasure to be here, Jeremy. Thanks for having me. You know, ever since I first made that company a wild success from nothing, I had people asking me for help and friends and, you know, can you help me with this? And I always, and again, I love teaching. So I was always consulting and teaching unofficially. Later on, I started a consulting practice, but I wasn't doing the right things. I wasn't getting the right clients. I was helping startups basically. Yeah. And a lot of startups fail.
It's tough.
No matter how much I help them or guide them, they just wouldn't take the action. So frustrating. Yeah. They had nothing to lose. So they didn't take the action. And I had done all this work and put all this together. And they weren't all like me with my fantasy sports game where I took all that action.
Right.
They were like, I got an idea, Steve. And I got referred to them. You know, I remember people in my church or this, I got referred. And I would help these people. And they wouldn't do anything. Or they would push back on everything.
Right.
And go, yeah, oh, what do you mean you're giving a super a World Series trip when everyone's given a hat? What are you doing? They would just push back on everything, and I wasn't getting good clients. And then what happened is I got married, my beautiful wife, Michelle, and she got downsized out of her company, was downsized, whatever. She lost her six-figure job, which was enabling me to be a dysfunctional, great consultant with no clients. I mean, barely any client, no really good paying clients. So, right. You know, and it's similar to business owners. You could be the world's greatest chiropractor. You can make the greatest adjustment in the world. If you're not going to get your marketing going, you got no one to adjust. You got an empty office. What a waste. So that was me as a consultant. I could help a lot of people, but I wasn't getting the thing going. And it was enabled by my wife paying the bills and bringing them up. Well, she lost that job. And I was like, you know, somebody here needs to be the man of the house and get a real job. And I figured that should be me. So I went and got a real job. And that's when I walked into and it wasn't really still a real job, of course, because again, my roots are paper route, vendor medicine, so we're all commission. Let's go. If you don't walk around the seats and sell popcorn, you go home with no money then.
Right.
By the way, a lot of kids did when the concerts are out or whatever. They just come in to watch the concert for free. I'm like, I hear it, and I might as well go home with $30. That's how we can go up in the front row and go backstage. It was kind of fun. But anyway, so I get to work. And I answer an ad that is a struggling law firm downtown Chicago. The phone is ringing off the hook with leads, says the ad. Too many leads was the headline. A salesperson's dream. Right. Too many leads. We don't know how to close them. We need somebody here who knows how to sell. I'm like, great opportunity. I'm going to go in. And I told him, I said, I'm going to go in. I'm going to show you how to sell these leads. The lawyers are trying to sell the leads. My goodness, let's not even start with the end. The sales and market attorney's trying to make sales. It was just horrible. I was like, on my interview, I was like, like, well, you know, attorneys, I don't know if you know, but they're like, well, no, you can't answer the phone because you're not vet. We don't know what you'll say when I just hand me the phone. Okay. Boom, 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 boom. You know, they were charging like $300 for something, whatever, because they were like, oh, all we have to do is file this form. That'll take me 15 minutes. I'm like, no. The guy just told you it's like a $15,000 problem you're going to solve. Give me the phone. I was like, for $1,500, we'll take care of that for you. Don't worry what we'll do. We'll just take care of it. It'll be all done. $1,500. Boom, credit card. Within 30 minutes, I'm like, there you go. You want me to do this? I'll put a system together. Only if I put a system together and then I get to hire more salespeople and teach them and build a sales force. And that's what I did. And within 9 months, I took that company from, they were on the brink of going out. They were just like, that's it. We're just going out of business. They were doing it as a night thing, trying to get this thing going. It was an emergency IRS, you know, they got a lien on your house thing like you see the ads on TV. So they were coming out of their job and at night trying to solve these problems and they're part-time. And they were about to give it up. Doesn't work. We get the leads, but we can't close these. You know, leads were easy. You get a list of everyone with a tax lien. It's a public records thing. And they got the calls. They couldn't get them to give them any money and to fix their problem.
Yeah.
I could. And 9 months later, we had 18 employees, was over $1 million business now, and things are rocking and rolling. So once again, but what happened was I was like, I looked into the office. There were three attorneys. One was a silent partner who just put in money, was working, had liked his cushy job at a firm. Another guy was doing all the legal work and trying to sell. And the third one was doing the marketing. He was getting the leads, getting the phone to him. Well, the marketing guy had on his desk a bobblehead doll of a grown man in a suit on a bull.
Right.
And I was like, what is that? I've seen baseball players. I've never seen a bobblehead of a grown man in a suit with big mutton chops riding a bull. What the heck is that? He goes, that's Dan Kennedy. I go, what does that mean? He goes, how do you think we get the phone ring? How do you think we get too many leads?
Yeah.
I study this Dan Kennedy market. I go out to a super, I go to Arizona every year where he lives. So I'm dating myself, this is way back. And I go out there to a conference and I put this together and that's how we get the leads, Dan Kennedy. So that's when it hit me. Who's this Dan Kennedy guy? What's this conference all about? How can you learn how to do this stuff? How could I get the leads so I can go back to my own consulting thing and get my own leads and close them? And so that was my introduction was, again, I knew right away, I didn't have to be skeptical and go, I wonder if that works.
Right.
It was like, how do you think the phone is ringing off the hook? It's called direct response marketing.
Yeah.
So that was my introduction. And now, I don't have it behind me here, I don't think. It's over by my computer. I have my own bobblehead doll of myself. And
of
I'm
you, okay.
A rhino. That's my nickname, known as the Rhino, and I have my own bobblehead doll, my own cartoons were Rhino, my own magazine is called Rhino Monthly, my own blog is called Rhino Daily, and my podcast is Rhino Daily, and I've got a collection of like 1,000 rhinos, people that, you know, what do you get, someone has everything, they get me rhinos from all over the world, so I have my own, but back then, I'd never seen a person on a bobblehead, and he was revered because of what he could do for businesses, and you being a chiropractor, you know, Dan started out by specializing in dentists and chiropractors, as you probably know.
Right.
Again, it goes back to that wow strategy. He could have helped anybody, but he said, I have help for chiropractors and for dentists. So
really targeted.
Full circle, you know, zero in on that target who. Later on, you want to have 2, 3, 4 target markets, 10, you want to go to later, but zero in on a real target who that you can speak to and deliver an irresistible offer that'll make them just say, I'd be an idiot to not do business with you and give you a shot to prove how good you are, that you're on time, that you do what you say. Well, I'll come back. I'll refer friends. But you got to get them in there and then find the way or the ways to get that irresistible offer to that chosen who. Real simple. And then, of course, you will be saying, wow. That's why I call it the wow strategy. Like, wow, didn't know it was that simple, Steve. Didn't even know this existed. I just thought I got to place a billboard or put my logo way on top of my ad and just be an auto repair guy and people will come in because, you know, cars break down. Yeah, no, doesn't happen.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
Well, Steve, we only have one.
Marketing is fun.
We only have one more minute, and I appreciate your time because I think
I have a list of like 400 questions.
I could keep
rambled.
I could keep asking you questions for the next 5 hours probably, and we could still go strong. But where should we point people towards, and what's one last thing we should leave them with? Because we talked about a lot of great direct response marketing advice.
Well, I do this. Now, I get overloaded, so you might want to get in quick or take it with a grain of salt, but I will, when I'm invited, which is a lot of time, do these interviews or I'm asked to speak or invite, and I will offer a free strategy session. This is not some thinly veiled sales pitch. Believe me, I don't even take on one-on-one clients anymore. I'm not looking for clients. Once in a while, sure, I will get a client out of this, but I love to get on the phone, in case you can't tell, and get have someone say, here's my problem. What do I do? And I'm like, ba boom, ba bang, and the person's excited. And I'm like, just report back to me the results, because there's that vicarious thrill that I love. So go to thewowstrategy.com or go to my name, SteveSipress.com, and you can fill out a little form. Now, I recommend that you fill that form out and make it seem really fun and interesting, whatever problem you're having. So I'm excited to call you, because anytime I mention this on any of these interviews, I get overloaded, and it's just me. And I am not giving 12. There's the phones ringing right now. I don't give 12 hours a day to be doing these, but I'll do a few of them.
Yeah.
But that's what I'll do for your for your readers, your listeners. I will give a free wow strategy session to help them to nail down those three simple areas and stop kicking the dog and start having a lot of fun with your business, because you've got a business. You're providing value. You might be paying payroll, you're paying taxes, you're paying suppliers, you're providing goods and services to the community, you're doing all these things, and yet 90% of businesses go out of business. And before they do, they struggle and you make no money. And you work too many hours and you have too much stress. That's terrible. I hate that. I hate that. You, now you're getting me all riled up and you didn't even do it. I hate that small business owners should be the highest paid, least stressed people in the world. That's the opposite.
Right.
So I'm on a mission to fix that. That's what I'm doing.
Well, go on your next call. I appreciate it, Steve. It's been fantastic. Thanks a lot.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.